Hey, I'm Babu here. I'm an architect with over 20 years of experience. Of late, I started working on Python as my primary language for doing some machine learning work. Python has been an important programming language, as you all know, for doing machine learning work. With its vast libraries and its communities, it's one of the leading languages. Python is not just for ML, as you all know. We can develop a host of different applications as well, and even web applications, console applications, you name it, and we can develop them in Python. As part of my work, I had to develop some REST APIs to host my ML models, which could be consumed by our clients. While there are some pretty important well-known tried and tested web frameworks that are available in Python, like Flask and Django, I came across a pretty new web framework called FastAPI. It's quite good based on till now whatever I have seen. On why I'm doing this tutorial, if there are documents, I feel it's better for newcomers to just go see someone doing the work and then picking up from there, instead of going through all the documents and trying on their own. And though they have a very good document on their website, I did not find any tutorial or a sample video on getting started with FastAPI. So I thought of creating this tutorial to help others who are either new to Python and want to learn a web framework, or those who would want to explore FastAPI and who are coming from Flask or Django. So that's about a small introduction about this tutorial as well as myself. And let's continue. Let's start off with the introduction to FastAPI. FastAPI is a modern, fast or high performance web framework for building APIs with Python 3.6 and above. It's one of the fastest Python frameworks available as measured by independent benchmarks. It is based on standard Python type hints. So using them, you can get automatic data validation, serialization, documentation. It includes deeply nested JSON documents, and you get code completion and validation on some popular editors. It is designed around open API, that is Swagger and JSON schema standards. It includes two alternative interactive API documentation systems that are generated automatically for Swagger and Redoc. Security and authentication is integrated without any compromise with database or database models. Let us look about some of the features that FastAPI supports. On par with Node.js and Go, thanks to Starlet and Pydantic. And it's one of the fastest Python frameworks available. It's fast code. It increases speed to develop features by about 200 to 300% compared to other web frameworks on Python. It reduces the bugs by about 40% of human-induced errors because of the libraries that it supports. It's intuitive. It has a great editor support, completion everywhere, and less time in debugging. It's very easy, designed to be easy to use and learn, less time reading documents. It minimizes code duplication, multiplies features from each parameter declaration, and thereby fewer bugs. With its production ready code and automatic interactive documentation, it's quite robust. It's standards based on and fully compatible with open standards for APIs. That should be sufficient for now with respect to introducing FastAPI and its features. In this video, I'll be using PyCharm as my IDE for developing the samples. You can use whatever IDE that you are comfortable with. You can as well go with PyCharm Professional if you have it, or you can go with the PyCharm Community Edition. There's one available, and a well-known IDE from Microsoft, which is Visual Studio Code. Whichever is comfortable for you, you can just start using that IDE. I go with PyCharm. This tutorial shows you how to use FastAPI with all its features step by step. Each section gradually builds on the previous one, but it's structured to separate topics so that you can go directly to any specific one to solve your specific API needs. It is also built to work as a future reference, so you can come back anytime and see exactly what you need. Before continuing with the next video, I would encourage you to go to this particular link provided to see the features that FastAPI provides, so that you will be well accustomed to what it provides and what you can expect out of it. In our next video in this series, we'll see how to get started with a simple Python based REST API using FastAPI. Hope this video has helped you in getting some basic knowledge about what FastAPI is and its features. If you have not done, please do subscribe to our channel. Thank you.